it's a very interesting season for us as Cricket South Africa. It's a very difficult one. We'll be spread very thin as the administrative wing of CSA, but at that, in preparing for this bumper season, you know, we've made a call to our affiliate members, you know, to come in as well and assist us in making sure that we can roll out this bumper season glitch-free. We've got the MSL that we will be launching soon, which is the second edition. We've got the England coming to our shores. We've got the Australians as well coming up here. We've got the Under-19 World Cup. We've got the Girls World Cup coming on next year as well. So a very difficult one for us, but nonetheless a very exciting one, because as Cricket South Africa, we enjoy being this busy. And we hope that, you know, going forward, every year can be this busy for us.
So Dane and the girls are busy preparing for, obviously, the World Cup. And we're very excited. This is a strong, strong team, stronger than what South Africans may realize, actually. We want to be able to showcase their strength, both on the field and in their mental game. Amazing ladies with their minds really set on bringing back some nice silverware for the country to celebrate. And we're ready to support them in any way we can. We're getting behind the women in a big way, not just from a cricket point of view, but really from a gender-based violence point of view. We want to be there to support women in this country and use our voice as CSA to support this cause. So heading into 2020, we have some big things planned from CSA's point of view. And we again implore on the media and on the fans and the general public to get behind us, to get behind the women of South Africa and elevate them to the place that they need to be.
We as Cricket South Africa, this is one year where we start our very aggressive campaign in supporting women's cricket. We just want everybody to watch the space in terms of what we've got coming for the women's. It's high time that we put our women up top, and we like to think that this is, you know, one of very few positive steps that we're going to take in making sure that we essentially put women's cricket to the helm, which is where it belongs.
This year it's two competitions. It's the 50 over competition, the 40 competition. So obviously our goal is to try and win both. But for us, it's always been about producing players to play for South Africa as well, and also play an exciting brand of cricket. We've always thrived on really playing exciting brand of cricket, which I think always kind of brings the crowds in for us. And, you know, we've always had great support in PE in East London, at St. George's Park and Buffalo Park. So for us, it's to kind of keep doing the same thing, but hopefully a little bit better this season, so we can get a slightly better result as well. Of course, that would be great. You know, we've come so close. We've had a shared trophy a few years ago, so, you know, we've rocked up against some really strong Titans team. But for us, the belief is there, and I think we've got a really good squad this year with a lot of young players who are really showcasing their talent to the world. So it'll really be exciting this season, and something we're really looking forward to.
Yeah, I think a lot of the guys are excited. When we're in the middle of the season, a lot of the guys want the season to end because they're hurting, the bodies are sore. And then when you're in the middle of pre-season, like, when's cricket going to start again? So it's that time again, so the guys are quite excited. I know I was like that before my tour to India. I was raring to go. I just want to get on a cricket field and just field for 4 days, you know. And then when you're in the moment, you're like, oh my goodness. I think a lot of the guys are quite excited. I think the first thing is to try get over the hurdle of that final that we keep getting into, and just maybe letting it slip in the one day stuff. So I definitely think that's probably one of a goal of ours. And in the 4 day stuff this year, we've got to do a lot better than what we did in the previous season. So hopefully we can finish in, you know, the top two. That for me would be really good, because we've got a young team and we in the 4 day stuff, and we're trying to grow it again and, you know, to build the youngsters up again.
Yeah, definitely we'll definitely strive to repeat that. I think that's going to be a challenge. Teams will obviously try and come out harder this season and try and beat us, and also try and get those trophies themselves. So for us, we try and maintain that, try and keep the standard we set last year, and hopefully we can achieve it by getting those trophies again. We do start with 4 four-day games. So for me personally, I'd love to do well there. I still have aspirations playing for the Proteas in Test cricket. So for me personally, hopefully I can build on that. Yes, I've played T20 and ODI cricket. I haven't played too much of it. Hopefully I can do well for the Lions to try and break into the team and sort of cement my spot in the Proteas team as well.
It's been a long pre-season so far. We've played a couple of pre-season games. We've been away, we've had some time off, we've come back, we're trailing again this week pretty hard. So we're looking forward to it, and obviously with the announcement of our new captain, a new leader of this group. We're a young team without our Proteas mostly, so we're looking forward to the season, and hopefully it's better than last. And personally, you know, looking to just get better, looking to grow as a cricketer. It's my second season here at the Titans now, and I just like to have a great season. I think fortunately for us, they're blocked off quite nicely, so you can concentrate on specific formats at a specific time. But generally for me, in the past, it's been 4-day cricket, and it's definitely the hardest format. And if If you win that, it's pretty satisfying.
We want to you know, grab this opportunity and show the rest of the world what we can do as a host country. As far as the sport of cricket is concerned, we haven't hosted world events in a very long time. So this is one of those steps that we're taking in showing not only the International Cricket Council, but the rest of the world essentially what we can do hosting a world event. And we'd like the entire country, you know, corporate SA and you know, the fans of cricket to come and support our team when they battle it out here at home. You know, the aspirations of essentially getting this trophy back and defending it.
This summer, our hashtag It's More Than Cricket stands true as we celebrate fans as part of the game, part and parcel of the game. Excellence on the field is great, obviously, but nothing if we have no fans to celebrate the excellence. So entertainment is the order of the day. Family fun, CSA is all about family fun. It's all about safety for fans. That's very key for us. And we want to make sure that the stadiums are safe for fans to come and have a lovely day with their kids and just enjoy the sun and enjoy the drinks, have a buri roll and maybe a castle if you're over 18, of course. Yeah, just lots of fun.